विद द इस्लामिक मंथ ऑफ शवाल ड्राइंग टू ए क्लोज, ए की डिसीजन कन्फ्रंट्स द मुस्लिम वर्ल्ड हाउ टू प्रोसीड विद हज विच इज़ ड्यू टू स्टार्ट एट द एंड ऑफ जुलाई वाइल द सऊदी गवर्नमेंट हैज़ नॉट टेकन ए डिसीजन येट ऑन वेदर और नॉट द पिलग्रिमेज विल गो अहेड. सम मुस्लिम स्टेट्स हैव अनाउंस्ड दैट दे विल नॉट बी सेंडिंग हाजीज दिस ईयर ड्यू टू द कोरोना वायरस थ्रेट. अमंग दीज आर इंडोनेशिया, मलाइशिया एंड ब्रुनेई. ऑफ कोर्स द चैलेंज इज कंसिडरेबल. लास्ट ईयर अराउंड 2 million बिलीवर्स मेड देयर वे टू द होली places to perform the annual pilgrimage. Enforcing the SOPs, health professionals recommend, especially with regard to social distancing, is next to impossible given the massive number of pilgrims. As it is, the Saudi health authorities put in a huge effort to ensure pilgrims arrive and stay healthy during Hajj. With COVID-19 now posing a serious challenge to global health systems, the risks involved with allowing even a limited number of Hajjis will be considerable, especially when the pilgrims fan out across the world after Hajj. The decision is not easy, but the Saudi government should announce its policy soon for the sake of clarity. Instead of allowing large numbers of people from across the world, perhaps a solution can be found by only allowing a small symbolic number of locals to perform the key in Makkah, Arafat, Mina, so that the religious obligation is fulfilled. Allowing a large number of believers to congregate may complicate the situation further, and even if Saudi Arabia decides to proceed as usual, each Muslim country, including Pakistan, must assesses the risks to its own citizen before allowing them to undertake the pilgrimage this year. Perhaps if ulema from different countries and schools of thoughts are consulted and the advice of health professionals in kept in view, a solution can be found for the pilgrimage to symbolically go ahead and ensure that Muslims' lives are not threatened by COVID-19.